We begin, though, tonight with the breaking news. Take a look. Live pictures tonight from West Hollywood and San Diego, almost 2 years after 52% of Californians voted to approve Proposition 8, a ban on same-sex marriage. The other 48% now has something to celebrate. Federal District Judge Vaughn Walker, Republican appointee, striking down the measure, ruling, quote, it cannot survive any level of scrutiny under the 14th Amendment's Equal Protection Clause. Contained within the ruling and hugely important in establishing legal precedent were dozens of findings of fact. Among them, according to the judge, sexual orientation is a fundamental characteristic of a human being. Same-sex couples are identical to opposite-sex couples in their ability to form a successful marital union. And the judge also directly rebutted opponents of same-sex marriage, saying permitting same-sex couples to marry will not affect either the number of or stability of opposite-sex marriages. California Governor Schwarzenegger, who was the defendant in this case in name only, unsurprisingly, is pleased he lost. This decision, he said today in a statement, affirms the full legal protections and safeguards I believe everyone deserves. Today's decision is by no means California's first milestone, nor our last, he went on to say, on America's road to equality and freedom for all people. Defense team, though, already planning an appeal, and Judge Walker has issued a stay against enforcing his ruling while that happens. That means, basically, same-sex couples in California are still barred from marrying for now. Just moments ago, I spoke with the two winning lead attorneys, David Boies and Ted Olson, who you'll remember were famously on opposite sides of the Supreme Court case that decided the 2000 election. They are at a rally in West Hollywood right now, so it's loud in the background. I spoke to them just minutes ago. We managed to talk despite the noise. Listen. Mr. Boies, for you, what are the most important points in the judge's decision?
That here in California, it doesn't matter.
The most important points in the judge's opinion were three.
It doesn't matter.
First, the judge held that marriage was a fundamental right for all individuals.
You never
Second,
really had a father.
The judge held that depriving gay and
really
lesbian citizens
if
of the right to marry seriously harmed them and seriously harmed their children. Third, the judge held that depriving gay and lesbian citizens of the right to marry had no benefit, no legitimate benefit to society.
Because here in
it
California,
didn't help preserve heterosexual marriage.
Each and every
it didn't help heterosexual couples. It didn't have any rational basis. And the judge found those three principles based not only on an extensive amount of evidence that we had put on, but on the things that the defendant's witnesses had actually admitted in court.
Mr. Olson, it does seem during the trial that your opponent's witnesses almost kind of argued in your favor. They seem to help you more than they hurt you.
And those of us who long
well, they absolutely, that it was the case. And in part, they were assisted by David Boies' skillful cross-examination. But the real fact was that we brought in evidence from experts, the leading experts from throughout the world on marriage, the history of discrimination, the damage that's done by discriminating against gay people, the raising of children and so forth. They did not have comparable evidence, and they did not have comparable experts. The experts that they did have really didn't have much to say, and they really had to admit that discrimination is wrong, that gays and lesbians can raise children, and they've raised children in a very, very happy family, and that discriminating against them does no good. It is un-American, it is unequal, and it's unfair. They had to admit this. I give great credit to David Boies for bringing that out in cross-examination, and the judge made the point at the end of the trial in this decision today that their evidence didn't amount to anything, and it was overwhelmed by the evidence and the experts that we put on.
And Mr.
Boies, keep in mind, they were defended by very, very good counsel. The problem with the defendant's case is not that they didn't put on their best case, but that simply their best case didn't have any rational basis for this kind of discrimination.
I mean, it seems like they had no evidence to argue the point that changing marriage, traditional marriage, that allowing same-sex marriages actually will negatively impact opposite-sex marriages.
That's exactly right. And the key issue that they had argued, the defendants had argued before trial, is that somehow allowing gays and lesbians to marry would harm heterosexual marriage. Now, there's a certain lack of common sense in that argument. But the key thing is that at trial, not only did we bring in empirical evidence would show that that had not happened in any of the places where you already have marriage between gays and lesbians. But the natural understanding of what the purpose of marriage was made it clear that that was not going to happen. And finally, even the defendant's own experts admitted that there was simply no evidence that there would be any harm to anyone, any heterosexual marriage, the institution of marriage, any harm to anyone that would come from ending this discrimination.
Mr. Olson, the strategy that the opponents of same-sex marriage used in the Prop 8 campaign was very different than what they argued in court. During the campaign, they were basically playing upon fears, parents' fears that their children would somehow be indoctrinated in school, but they didn't use that argument in court. Why not?
Well, I think that what they realized is that you are correct. That they, during the campaign, they argued that it was necessary to pass Proposition 8 to protect our children from thinking that it was okay to be gay, that it was okay for gay people to have the normal marital relationship that the rest of our neighbors do. They realized that that sounded and was discriminatory, that it recognized or it called out for people to think upon gays and lesbians as different and unequal and less favored. So they abandoned that during the trial. They knew it would not work. And then they resorted to this idea that somehow allowing your neighbors to get married would somehow discourage heterosexual couples from getting married or having children. And the evidence didn't support that. So they tried one thing during the campaign, then they abandoned that, and they tried something else during the trial, and that didn't work either.
And Mr. Boies, to those who say, why not have domestic partnerships, why marriage?
The communities that have come to realize
what the judge found and what all the evidence showed was that domestic partnerships were not equal to marriage. That when the state sponsors discrimination against gay and lesbian couples by saying you have to have this second class status, you can't have marriage like normal people. That is the worst kind of state-sponsored discrimination. We have a lot of areas in this country where we still have a long ways to go before we achieve the kind of equality that our country was founded believing in. But this is the only area in which the state actually has official state-sponsored, state-enforced discrimination. And when the state says to gay and lesbian couples, you're not good enough for marriage, you have to be settled for a domestic partnership, that is straight-out discrimination. And the judge found that it harmed gays, it harmed lesbian couples, it harmed their children, and it had no benefit to anybody.
That was attorneys David Boies and Ted Olson at a rally in West Hollywood. Apologize for the background noise. So what happens next? We'll hear from both sides of the marriage debate. Evan Wolfson, Maggie Gallagher ahead.